If you've heard anything about me, you've heard that there's an Asian man running for president who wants to give everyone $1,000 a month. And all of those things are true. We will take this case all the way to the White House and win because the opposite of Donald Trump is an Asian man who likes math.
All right, in a crowded field of 2020 Democratic candidates, Andrew Yang is standing out. The former tech executive wants to give us all, give every American over 18 a universal basic income of $1,000 per month. Why? Well, let's ask him. Andrew Yang, Democratic candidate for president, joins me now. Thank you very much for being with us. Universal basic income, $1,000 a month for everyone, including, say, Allison Camerota?
Yes, that's exactly right. And we need to make this move because we're in the midst of the greatest economic and technological transformation in the history of our country. The reason why Donald Trump's our president today is that we automated away 4 million manufacturing jobs in Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin. And my friends in Silicon Valley know full well that we're about to do the same thing to millions of retail workers, call center workers, fast food workers, truck drivers, and on through the economy.
Not to shorthand it, but there are people who joke that this is the robot apocalypse that's coming. You look at automation as a threat to the fabric of the nation, yes?
Yeah, very much so. And you can look around our main streets. 30% of malls and stores are closing in the next 4 years because Amazon is soaking up another $20 billion in commerce every year. So you don't think of that as robots because robots don't just walk into the main street and sit behind the counter. But if you go to an Amazon fulfillment center, you'll see it's wall-to-wall robots. So this is all real. It's not science fiction.
Is Amazon the enemy?
Well, Amazon is a huge winner in this system that we built, and we need to make it so that more people can share in the progress that's being driven by all this innovation.
So universal basic income, $1,000 a month, is an insurance policy against the threat of automation.
Yeah, it helps give tens of millions of Americans a real path forward. And the thing that excites me the most is you can see that it would improve people's health, nutrition, it would elevate graduation rates, it would improve people's mental health. But it would help people make transitions in a time of historic change.
If you get pushed out of a job by automation, how's $12,000 a year going to change your life?
Well, I've looked at the numbers around the country, and I've spent the last 7 years helping create several thousand jobs in the Midwest and the South. And so $1,000 a month would be a game changer for tens of millions of Americans, but it would also lead to 2 million new jobs because of all the economic activity. And it would make our labor force much more dynamic because right now a lot of Americans are stuck in place and are having a hard time moving for different opportunities.
Why does the 1% deserve $1,000 a month as does someone making $35,000 a year?
Well, if you look at our own country, Alaska has had a dividend for the last 38 years, and it's wildly popular in large part because it's universal. So it's not seen as like, you get it, I don't, I'm giving it to you. Instead, it's just a right of citizenship in Alaska. And because of that, it's very popular. We should do the exact same thing in the rest of the country.
Alaska's got about 700,000 people and a lot of oil. America's got, what, 350 million people?
Yes.
And a huge national debt. This will add to that.
Well, it won't necessarily, because if you look around, again, one of the big winners from this process is going to be Amazon, and Amazon paid zero in federal taxes last year. So what we have to do is we have to join every other advanced economy and have a value-added tax that would give the American people a tiny slice of every Amazon sale and every Google search.
VAT often adds taxes and burdens on people who don't make that much money. You're talking about purchases on common everyday goods.
Oh, well, you can tailor a VAT so it falls more heavily on, let's say, luxury goods than consumer staples. But we need to make this kind of move because if you have things like artificial intelligence, right now our income tax system will do a very, very poor job of getting some of those resources in the hands of the American people.
I want to ask you some questions on other subjects. You worked at Manhattan Prep. You ran Manhattan Prep, which is a test preparation company.
Yes, that's right.
Here in the city. It is the type of place that is now seen as tied up in this entire higher education machine complex. How do you see the college admission scandal recently, and what's a way to solve it?
Yeah, so the college admission scandal is a symptom of all sorts of problems. I mean, college has gotten 2.5 times more expensive, even though it has not changed in quality. And the admissions rates have plummeted because of the competitiveness to get in.
The automation of getting in. The common application is this form of automation.
Yeah, that's one reason. But a lot of it is that people are incredibly stressed out about their children's futures. And so they think if their kid doesn't get into a certain school, it's going to be the end of the world. And you reflect on that, you're like, wait a minute, why is that? And the reason that is that our economy has changed so that if you feel like if you don't get a certain sort of degree, then your child is going to have a very bleak path forward.
Do you think organizations like Manhattan Prep add to that anxiety by creating this place where people think they need to go to improve their test scores?
Well, what I did after Manhattan Prep was acquired is I went and started an organization, Venture for America, that helped train hundreds of entrepreneurs around the country because, in part, of what you're describing, which is we need to create a more diverse set of paths for our young people so they don't think they can only do one of a few things in a few places.
The president is having all kinds of issues on the border. He wants to alter, if not end, much of the asylum process. How would you solve what's going on at the border right now with more and more families coming over with more and more kids? How would you get them or process them more efficiently?
Yeah, so I'm the son of immigrants. I feel very, very strongly that this country has an important role to play. But we need to both secure the border and do a much more efficient job of helping process people who are applying for asylum under our processes.
How?
Because right now there's like a multi-month wait process.
How?
A lot of it is putting more resources to work and also giving people more authority on the ground, because right now a lot of people's hands are tied with bureaucracy.
Not judges, people who aren't judges, you want to give them more authority?
Well, you know, to me it's unacceptable that you have, in some cases, like an 8 or 10 or 12 month waiting period. So it could be that we need more judges.
All right. You say you have qualified for the Democratic debates in June and July because by your accounting you've got the fundraising and the money from the number of people.
And the polling.
And the polling. When you are standing on that stage with the other Democratic candidates, what is going to distinguish you? Why should Democratic voters pick you instead of the other Democratic candidates?
Well, I believe I have the right vision for the country to help create a path forward for tens of millions of American families who right now are being sidelined and swept aside by all these economic changes. And unfortunately, most political leaders do not want to confront the magnitude of this fourth industrial revolution that we're in the midst of. Now, because of my work in technology and business over the last number of years, I can see it plain as day, and I can see what we need to do to move our country forward.